Hello everyone, it's the Historical Gamer here. Quite a large update today. Again, just a slight deviation from my historical stuff. I've been working on my Dwarf Army for Old World, the new release of Warhammer Fantasy Battle. And I've got quite a lot of progress, so I'm quite excited to share this actually. Been waiting for the new starter box to be released, and I think that's coming out soon. I've been sort of looking on eBay and picked up a few things. Back when I had a dwarf army nearly 30 years ago, slayers were like one of the cool items that I really liked. And I guess I'm kind of guessing that the starter set's probably not going to have any slayers in because they're quite cool rare units. So I thought that'd be worth investing in. I bought five. There you go. I think they're from the latest version before it was discontinued. And they're absolutely amazing figures. So, I really enjoy painting these. A massive difference from painting World War II and Napoleonic stuff. We've all got green trousers because it goes quite well with the ginger red hair. It looks just look great. They're gonna look great on the tabletop. I've got five. I've got some more actually. I'll just show you in a second. I've looked at buying lots of other things, but they're going for crazy prices on eBay and. I managed to pick up I think I might have shared this in another video actually, or maybe not, but just get the box. An unopened in shrimp wrap box of Warriors, the latest version, so here's the box. And I got it for like 35 quid, which is pretty good, I think, because some of them are for sale for like 100 quid on eBay, which is ridiculous. The sculpts aren't great, they're showing their age a little bit, but there's so much character in them. I went for kind of a blue and off-white color. I just picked one of them out. Literally only finished these last night. My dwarf army, one of my warrior regiments, which was all metal back in the day, was kind of like a blue and white theme, so I went with that, and then with a slightly darker blue and gold on the shield. Really enjoyed painting them. Big chunky sort of details, big hands, big beards, and chain mail and stuff. I think they come out quite nicely as a unit. Maybe pick out another one. Let's pick out the leader, the champion. He's so cool with his kind of like almost Asterix-esque wings on his helmet and lots of gold and medallions and whatever that stuff is. With his blue cloak. So yeah, really chuffed with that. I think the Dwarf Force is going to be released soon with from Warhammer. So I'll wait and see what's in that and probably pick that up next. Banner. Literally just this morning, so it's still kind of wet. I've just painted the freehanded design on the front. I'd finished the whole unit last night, apart from having something written on the banner. So I dug out my old Codex Army Book, whatever you call this thing from the 90s. I looked in the back and it was made in 1993, I think. Yeah, 93. There we go. So this is kind of my era of being a young teenager. I was looking through here and I looked at the runes and looking for some inspiration for what I could put on the banner. Those of you will know that's a rune G and a rune 10. So that says G10, which is a number that a designation that's important to me. This warrior regiment is G10. There we go. So that's looking really cool. Like I said, I might just wait for. It looks like from the stuff I've seen online that they're going to use some of the Age of Sigmar stuff for like hammerers, iron drakes, long beards, etc. Once they become available, I'll probably pick those up next. I don't think I need any more warriors. Although there is an option to have them with double-handed weapons, so I'll probably do that eventually too. The only other thing I've got is I've got some more. Slayers as well, so I think this was an absolute. Well, is it, can you call anything from Games Workshop a bargain? Maybe not, but I think I paid sort of 45 quid for those, which is kind of reasonable-ish. They're usually about 5 or 10 quid each if you get them individually, but I managed to buy this set here for 45 quid for a full 10. It's got the command. It's got this really. I don't know what this one is, but I remember this from back in the day. It's got this kind of champion figure. He's amazing. What's this? A musician with his giant horn. No pun intended. What have we got? Banner bearer in here as well. It's the one with the troll's head that fits on the top. Let me just dig that out. Yeah, cool. And there's enough variations. There are a couple of repeats, but not too many. There's these guys, I don't have these. Put that in. There's a guy with the two axes over his head, similar to this guy in the unit. You see him there. But he's looking to the left, so it gives you a bit of variation. This guy as well is different to the others. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do with them. I think, so unit 5 is too small. And I've got no command, so I'll definitely paint up those three command figures plus another two, so that gives me a unit of 10. And then this, as I said, this box set here, which is a bit of a steal, to be honest. I might just paint all of them up. So I've got 15 Slayers, because I really like them, and I think they're cool. But yeah, that's where I am with it. I wasn't expecting to paint this. I just kind of got a little bit enthused with the new stuff that's coming out again, re-releasing old things and going back to ranks of figures instead of individual base stuff, which I didn't really like so much for fantasy. Yeah, but that's where I am. That's the size of my force at the moment. So one unit of 16 Dwarf Warriors with hand weapon and shield and 5 Slayers soon to be expanded. But yeah, that's it. I mean, I'll probably, I don't know if I'll do the Slayers next. I might move back to my Rifleman, so I'll switch target, but we'll see. So anyway, thanks very much for watching. If you like this kind of content, please do like, comment and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.